So first, thanks a lot for giving me the opportunity to give here a short overview of the current activities of this committee on Earth System Modeling, which is part of the GIGOS Bureau of Products and Standards introduced recently by Detlev. So let me first remind you of the initial purpose and overall goals of this committee. The ESM committee is usually typically not the place where groundbreaking new scientific results are produced, of course, but this is rather a forum to discuss and develop options and strategies for the adequate adaptation of models to geodetic requirements in order to make them fit for geodetic applications on the one side, and also to support processes that make geodetic data usable for the improvement of model simulations on the other side. Thus, the main intention and purpose of this group is so rather to raise awareness and to establish or to strengthen a link between geodetic products and process models. And one of the keywords in this context is physical consistency. What is extremely important, you know, for applications of models to geodetic data. But however, people running large models, large weather or climate models, typically do not care at all about consistency, as for instance, mass, energy, or momentum conservation. So some aspects, or let's say sub-goals, of the group are listed here, which are important to achieve consistency. And these are, for instance, consistent relationships of the geodetic parameters, such as earth rotation, gravity field, and deformation, as well as consistent interactions of model compartments. And the homogeneous processing is important for improved analysis, for effect separation, as well as finally for the interpretation and prediction of the geodetic observations. And on the other side, model-based integration of observations based on different techniques can be used as a tool for consistency checks of various observational products. So you see, unfortunately, I only have some boring text slides, so the entertainment factor is really quite reduced, but anyway, comedy might be added later, and I will give you one example in the over next slide. So the main recent activities of the group concentrated on the further development of data assimilation algorithms, and the discussion, this is a very important point, I think, of opportunities to implement algorithms based on artificial intelligence. Yes, another issue was the adequate consideration of effects related to loading and self-attraction due to surface mass loading, and the identifications of opportunities to provide realistic model errors as well as uncertainties. Here are some more concrete examples. For instance, the implementation of particle filter algorithms and comparison with traditional approaches, such as in particular Kalman filtering approaches. The application of neural networks for downscaling. On this, I will give an example in the next slide. The consideration of lateral variations of the Earth's structure in solid Earth models and viscoelastic and elastic solid Earth models. And another point was on the coupling of these models with the near surface fluid standalone systems. And as I mentioned in recent discussions, special attention was in particular on the opportunities to combine the classical numerical model approaches with methods based on artificial intelligence or machine learning. And since this is a rather new and complex development, this topic will certainly be important also in the near future. But let me give an example that might hopefully underline the great potential we see from such a combination of classical model approaches with artificial intelligence. Here on the left-hand side, you see GRACE-like gravity observations over South America with the typical low spatial resolution. And after implementing a neural network into a numerical water storage model, you can train the network by model hindcasts in order to reveal the finer patterns of water storage variations shown in the middle. And an example is here shown in the middle, and you can see, for instance, clearly the river structures and all other finer structures in the water storage patterns. Such a procedure can in principle be applied to all monthly graze solutions in order to reveal the temporal variability of water storage with a significant higher spatial resolution than those initially derived from graze as shown on the left-hand side. And as I mentioned at the beginning, it's not the core task of the committee to produce such results, but the example might demonstrate why we regard this topic as very important, especially in the context of supporting the utilization of geodetic products in other disciplines. What are the planned foci for the near future? Here are again a few examples. First, we plan to continue the feasibility studies investigating opportunities to constrain dynamically coupled model systems. And this is still a problem that is only partly solved so far. And another focus will be on the assessment of the quality of ocean tide models. And since ocean tides are still one of the most important limiting factors of the quality of several geodetic monitoring products, we will in particular discuss the opportunities for further model improvements. My personal impression is that we will in particular come to focus on the quality of the representation of minor tides in ocean tide models. And last not least, I think we have to meet the challenges related to upcoming hardware developments, because the transition from high performance to exascale computing will certainly significantly impact our modeling activities. Yes, that's from my side. Thank you very much for your attention.